Welcome to the official first gameplay recording for Resident Evil Remake 2. What I'm looking at right now is just a complete list of records that I unlocked during my first playthrough with Claire. The reason I'm starting us off from this point is just to get all of the other story stuff out of the way in the beginning so we can really get into the meat and bones of this game. If you're interested in seeing what I did before this, you can catch the video on my Discord channel. Otherwise, we will pick it up from here and continue forward. Currently, in my space provided, I have my high capacity mag, which is what you get when you unlock the office upstairs, the waiting room. You'll also notice that there is a spade door key up there as well, and there is one that will open this door as well. Another thing that you'll notice is I actually do have the Samurai Edge pistol from completing the game once. Two herbs. Like I said in my first video, but we'll reiterate here, you don't want to use herbs by themselves. They're always better to mix together. In this case, I've tucked away my first aid spray, some extra ammo, and these herbs so that I can continue to fix things as I please. So as we continue with this gameplay, we'll make our way down this hallway. This is where you can start to see all of the different zombies and everything really coming together. These windows, it's in your best interest to board up the windows as you see fit once you get extra boards. This is another gore intense scene coming up. One of my favorites in the entire game. Really love the way that looks. As we continue to make our way down this hallway, you'll notice you're able to interact with the windows. That is just because you're able to board them up. You bump into that body, it will fall. Here, you'll notice this requires another key, the Shamrock key. As you continue down this hallway and check your map, you'll notice that there's nothing here. It's important to check all corners and crevasses just to make sure you've gotten everything the game has to offer. This woman will break through this window. You don't have any boards for it right now, so she can just do as she pleases. Not even really worried about her existence too much, but we'll shoot her in the legs anyways. It's best to hit these guys in the legs just to knock them down. If you do that, then obviously they're going to be crawling, but headshots in this game don't necessarily mean a kill. As you can see here, as we enter this operations room, you'll notice that the room is red. That means you are still searching the room and there are still items and such that you can pick up. This is why it's important to check every corner and all areas of every room that you enter into. Once you come over to this desk, you'll get a record of events slip, which reads as follows. September 25th. We're turning the station into a temporary shelter due to the massive sudden outbreak. All police personnel have been instructed to make the safety of the citizens their top priority as we try to accommodate as many of them as possible. September 25th. One of the refugees attacked us in the middle of the night, resulting in the death of one officer and injuring three others. The person in question was quickly restrained. We believe this is simply a case of somebody snapping under intense stress. September 26th. A mob attack. A mob attacked the station today, resulting in a number of casualties. A few survivors were able to make it safely behind the emergency shutters, but surrounded as we are, it will be hard for any of us to escape this place. We're not sure we can fix any of our comm equipment, so we remain cut off from the outside world. And then September 27th. There was another clash on the west side of the station around 1 p.m. 12 people died, and there was only a handful of survivors left. Everything is falling into disarray here. David Ford. And we'll tuck that away in our handy-dandy equipment slots over here. Next, you'll come over to this whiteboard, which will just give you the map of the first floor police station. This is super important. Now you can see all of the extra rooms and spaces available to you. And that means this room has been completely checked out. Now you'll notice there's not another door here, but if you look at the map, there's an arrow. So you'll want to quickly make your way up here and over into this next hallway. Like so. Well, you will encounter a zombie trying to get into a vending machine after, of course, you search this body and get the ammo. If you look at the map now, you'll notice that this hallway is blue. That means you've searched everything here. The next thing that we're going to take care of is the fat zombie who wants to get into the vending machine. Again, reload. Hit him in the legs. So, and I don't think he's getting back up. Make sure to reload after you're done if you use that many bullets. This door to your right-hand side is going to be locked. So we'll come down this hallway next. This door to the west office will be open. I'm going to take care of the zombies that are in here. I don't even know if he's dead. I think he's dead now. Once you do that, be sure to have another look around and make sure there's nothing else in here that can kill you. Come over here. Grab the rookie's first assignment, which reads as Leon S. Kennedy. We're putting you on a very special case for your first assignment. Your mission is to unlock your desk. The key to success is in the initials of our first names. And put the letters in order on your desk. There are two locks, one on each side of the desk. Make sure you get them both. Basically, your first task is to remember your fellow officers' names, but you figure that out much out, right? Good luck, Leon. By the way, it might take a little work to get Scott to give you straight answers. Lieutenant Brahan? Be glad you're not here, rookie. And so this is what the lock is going to look like. There will be two on each side, and we are just going to leave those alone for a moment. Once you come over here, you're going to grab the operation report, which reads September 28th, 2:30 a.m. It's down to just me and three others. No weapons, no ammo, too many skirmishes have drained us mentally and physically. We're not going to make it. Officer Phillips once suggested we escape through the sewers. Apparently, there's a secret tunnel under there. This place left over from its museum days. I brushed her idea off before, but now it's not sounding all that bad. Yeah, there's no proof that there's even a tunnel, or that the sewers aren't infected with zombies, but I don't want to sit here and wait to die either. It's a long shot, but I'm going to try and find out what I can about that tunnel. So, Elliot Edwards is presumably the same dude who was doing the officer's notebook. That is, I don't know if that is confirmed or me just simply speculating, but based off of what it says in the operation report and what the man scribbled down, it leads me to believe that he was, in fact, the officer who created that notebook. And then we'll come over into this next office, which is the West office, and knife this guy because he will stand up. Trust nobody, trust no bodies. Just keep knifing. Unless, of course, you want to shoot him. I just didn't deem it a good use of ammo. You'll notice that your knife actually does have a health bar, so I'm going to have to start conserving that. And then you'll find another safe. And maybe something more. So you'll notice that the dial locks are labeled by exclamation points. And then you can come over here, grab the gunpowder, which is extremely important, and then read the uses of gunpowder. It tells you about how you make handgun ammo and additional rounds. So, two things of gunpowder will make you handgun ammo. Gunpowder plus high grenade gunpowder make you acid rounds. High grenade gunpowder, white times two, will make some machine gun ammo. It's all about combining different things and seeing what you can get out of them. We're actually going to come back to open both of these safes. But for now, we are going to continue to move forward. No, we're not. We missed something. I presume the map is just telling us that we need to open those safes. But can never be too careful. Yep. A locker can be opened. And inside, you'll find some more handgun ammo, which still makes this room red. We're going to go off of the assumption that that just wants us to open those safes, and we're going to leave it be for now. This door is locked by that key. It's actually a shortcut into the main hall. But you can head this way and walk back out the way you came to enter the hallway again. Once you continue down this hallway, you'll see another zombie at the window. And then this is super important. So you can grab these wooden boards, come over here, grab this herb, and then come over here and place the boards over the window to keep that dude back. Once he breaks the glass, I'll go ahead and shoot him in the face. The next room is the dark room, which is technically another save point. So this is where I'll demonstrate what you can really do with the herbs. We'll pull out the mixed herbs that we already have. We will take this one and combine it. And together we will get three G's of herb. This will fully restore your health, and of course, because I'm stingy, we will tuck it back into our storage area. You could turn on the lights in here. Grab this red herb, put it in here. Red herbs do something different, and it can't be used as is. We also don't have any film on us at the moment, so we can't use that. This is another save spot, and we're going to take the red herb and just put it into storage until we can use it at a later date. It's also telling us that we have not explored everything, so we'll open up this locker, grab the handgun ammo, open up this locker, grab the gunpowder. We don't need to make ammo right now. I'm going to tuck away the gunpowder. And that should be everything for the dark room. So you can save here. And like I said before, these are my first two games. This is the one that we're currently doing, third from the top. We are not actually going to save. You're going to come out of the hallway, like, so, that dude's still banging away. We will make our way up the stairs, make sure everything is blue. Come across this corpse. Just give her some knives. Ooh, this is not good. Okay. One thing that I can complain about with this game is its camera angles are wonky to me. So she's gonna go down. We're gonna knock him down. Like so, we're gonna grab our knife and stop using it to kill things. Take that back. We will stab him one more time. And he will bite us again, which will knock us into orange health. This is one of those situations where it's best to just move. In my case, moving into the men's locker room. So as you look around here, you'll open up these lockers, and of course there's a dude. Open up this locker. It has a combo to it. This one will give you flame rounds. This one is empty. This is a portable safe, which we will do in a second. And then this is portable safe instructions. We don't need that. We'll make sure we can't open anything else before I open up this safe. So with everything, you can look at it, examine it, like so. Like this, with these portable safes, you can examine it, and then you click X. So you want to find the combination going in order of those arrows. So like this one is green, that one's red. It will just reset what you did. So that's what they all look like. Now we are just going to try and find the order. This one is bottom under the D. One of these three. Nope. Yes. Nope. Oh, but that one's better to start off. So, top. Bottom. That one. So, boom. 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 No, but that one will come in sequence soon enough. Boom. Damn it. Boom. 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 A. Ah. Oh. Nope. So we're gonna take it from the top. This one. Gah. Boom. Boom. Do I keep doing that? Go. This one is last. So technically it would go this, 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 that. No, 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 no. Reset. Reset. This. Second, first, last. Here. Skipped one. Just so everybody is aware, this is randomized every time you play. That will open the save. Sorry that took so long. Once it cracks open, you will get a spare part. This is super important. You want to keep that. This ammo is not for any of your pistols. But now you can come out here. Hopefully not bump into that dude. This is where we start moving. Very quickly. Back to the stairs. And into the safe area where we will tuck our goodies away and grab our first aid spray. Tuck this away. Tuck that away. Tuck this away. We will use this here. And then we will do our second save. Third save. We do need to finish upstairs before this. I decide to end this video, so we're going back at it. This guy is still, of course. I should not have done that. He has some rounds in him. We're not going to go back that way. We're actually going to continue up these steps. Down. Pick this ammo up, reload, but keep moving, come down here, this is another padlock, come in here, pick up the blue key, which is awesome, and now you'll see on the map all of these doors that are locked with blue. We also missed handgun ammo. We can now open. We will continue down this hallway. Into this room to grab these boards. I don't know what this substance on the wall is, and we're just gonna leave it at that. We will come over here to open crates like this. You just... Oh, don't have a knife. You can't shoot them either. You have to break them with your knife to open. We'll come over to this room, which will bring you to the library. Now, once you're in here, there's going to be quite a few zombies in here. They're obnoxious. You can choose to juke them downstairs and just take the ladder, which is what I am going to do. This is a puzzle that you won't be able to finish unless you follow a certain order of events. Early on, for me, I'm just interested in grabbing what I can before I head out. There is the knife. We will move around him. Use the key on this door. Open it up, and boom. We are back into this lobby area. Before I end the video, we are going to go around and open the blue doors as we see fit. I believe there's one down the end of this hallway. Door, yep. You don't want to be in a situation where you haven't unlocked these doors yet and you're getting chased. So just do that the moment you get the blue key. We'll head down these stairs next. Past Marvin, it will trigger a cutscene. If you guys want the audio to be turned up for the dialogue, just go ahead and let me know and I will adjust the videos accordingly. Now we'll go over here and unlock this door, which is another one you want to make sure to get unlocked as soon as possible. And it brings you back into this room, which creates yet another shortcut. So now that that's over and done with and all these doors have been unlocked, I presume. Saw another. Okay. Yep. So those doors are unlocked now, and we're not gonna worry about the right side at all. Just saved. If I have to, I'll unlock the door again on the next playthrough. That we do. But ending this video here, this is what we have so far in the inventory. Since I have a little bit of time left, you want to keep the keys in your inventory, by the way. So you'll notice it has a red check mark in the corner. That means that you're done with it, and you've done everything that you can with it. I'm not just gonna throw it away or whatever. I am going to stick it in the inventory like so. This key, we're done with. Awesome. We're going to extract 2 gunpowders to make ourselves some more ammo to use. Like so. And then store this. Move this up here. Now we have 15 rounds, counting the 3 that are already loaded in the revolver. And by doing all of that, we have set ourselves up good for the next playthrough. Thank you for watching. Feel free to like, comment, and subscribe.